बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। टुडेज लेक्चर इज अबाउट द फिजियोलॉजिकल एनाटॉमी ऑफ द डायनसेफलॉन। इन दिस लेक्चर यू विल लर्न वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द डायनसेफलॉन एंड द फिजियोलॉजिकल एनाटॉमी ऑफ डिफरेंट पोर्शंस ऑफ द डायनसेफलॉन। दैट मीन्स थैलेमस, हाइपोथैलेमस, सबथैलेमस and epithalamus. The diencephalon consists of third ventricle, and four very important structures: thalamus, hypothalamus, subthalamus, and epithalamus. The fluid-filled spaces within the cerebral hemispheres are called lateral ventricles. These are paired structures, paired fluid filled spaces, and the space at the center of diencephalon is called third ventricle. The paired lateral ventricles in an adult brain are useful feature for identifying the diencephalon. Whenever you see the paired lateral ventricles in the brain section, you know that the tissue surrounding them is the telencephalon. The diencephalon on its lateral surface is bounded by internal capsule that is shown here. This black band is internal capsule on both sides. As the diencephalon is divided into two symmetrical halves, so its upper part is formed by the, that means the superior part, it is formed by the thalamus, while the in the inferior portion it is formed by the hypothalamus. The medial surface of thalamus is connected with the opposite side of the thalamus through interthalamic connections. The inferior surface is continuous with the tegmentum of midbrain. As the diencephalon forms a central core of the brain just superior to the midbrain, it is almost completely, as you can see from this diagram, it is almost completely surrounded by two cerebral hemispheres on each side. and contains numerous nuclei involved in variety of sensory and motor processing between higher and lower brain centers. The portions of diencephalon in the cavity of third ventricle are called circumventricular organs. Circumventricular organs are so called because they lie in the wall of the third ventricle. They lie in the wall of the third ventricle and they can monitor chemical changes. They can monitor chemical changes in the blood because they lack cerebrospinal fluid. Ventricular organs includes parts of the hypothalamus, parts of the pineal body, and parts of the pituitary. Glands. Therefore, these regions coordinate homeostatic activities of the endocrine and nervous system. So the first portion among structures of the diencephalon is thalamus. The thalamus is about 3 cm in length and make up 80% mass of the diencephalon. The thalamus consists of oval masses of gray matter organized into nuclei with interspersed tracts of white matter. There are gray masses of thalamus called the intermediate masses that join the right and left halves of the thalamus, as we discussed in the previous diagram. In about 70% of human brains, a vertical Y-shaped sheet of matter called the intermedullary lamina . This is a Y-shaped matter that is called internal medullary lamina, and it divides the gray matter of right and left sides of the thalamus. There are 7 major groups of nuclei on each sides of the thalamus. The first one is the medial group of neurons, and this medial group of nuclei, it basically is concerned with emotions, memory, and learning. Then is the anterior group, and anterior group, it is concerned with the emotions. Then is the ventral anterior nuclei and the ventral lateral nuclei and the ventral posterior nuclei. These three nuclei, the ventral anterior, it receives, or you can say it is in connection with the basal nuclei. So it plays a role in control of movement. While the ventral posterior group, it receives information that passes from the periphery to the cerebral cortex. It passes through the ventral posterior group of nuclei, and it is concerned with the somatic sensations. That includes touch, pressure, pain, vibration, etc. Then is the lateral group of nuclei, lateral dorsal, then lateral posterior group of nuclei. Now these lateral group of nuclei, they receive input from the limbic system, superior colliculus, and also from the cerebral cortex. So these are basically concerned with the expression of behavior, expression of emotions, and also help in integrating sensory information. Then are the lateral geniculate nucleus, and lateral geniculate nucleus, it is concerned with the vision, and the medial geniculate nucleus, it is concerned with hearing and relays auditory impulses to the cortex. Then are the Meldine nuclei. These Meldine nuclei, they are concerned with relaying information regarding olfaction and memory. Then are the reticular nuclei. These are very important nuclei. They surround the lateral aspect of the thalamus, and they monitor and filter activities of other nuclei of thalamus. The thalamic neurons send axons to the cortex via the internal capsule. As a rule, the axons of each internal capsule carry information to the cortex about the contralateral side of the body. Therefore, if a thumbtack entered the right foot, it would be relayed to the left cortex through internal capsule. By the left thalamus. But how does the right foot know that what the left foot is doing? One important way is communication between the hemispheres by the axons in the corpus callosum. The second important structure of the diencephalon is hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is a small part of the diencephalon located inferior to the thalamus. This is thalamus and it is located inferior to the thalamus. It is composed of a dozen or so nuclei in four major regions. Number one, the mammillary region. Mammillary region, it includes the mammillary bodies and posterior hypothalamic nucleus, the red in color. This is the mammillary region. Then the second region is tuberal region, and it includes dorsomedial, ventromedial, ventromedial nuclei plus the infundibulum. Which connects with the pituitary gland. The median eminence is slightly raised region that encircles the infundibulum. Then is the supraoptic region, and it contains paraventricular nucleus, then anterior hypothalamic nucleus, and then supraoptic nucleus. Axons from the paraventricular and supraoptic nuclei from the hypothalamo-hypophyseal tract extends through the infundibulum to the posterior lobe of the pituitary gland, and they are concerned with the secretion of antidiuretic hormone and oxytocin. Then the fourth group of nuclei in the hypothalamus are the preoptic region, that is anterior to the supraoptic region, and it includes lateral preoptic nucleus and medial preoptic nucleus. These nuclei are concerned with regulating autonomic activities. Sensory impulses related to both somatic and visceral senses arrive at the hypothalamus, as do impulses from receptors for vision, taste, and smell. Other receptors within the hypothalamus monitor osmotic pressure, blood glucose level, and other activities. So, in short, the hypothalamus plays a role in the control of autonomic nervous system, regulation of emotions, and behavior, regulation of eating, and drinking, control of body temperature, then regulation of circadian rhythm and state of consciousness. And the hypothalamus is also concerned with the production of hormones. autonomic function is very important function of the hypothalamus, and through autonomic regulation, the basically hypothalamus plays a role in regulation of blood pressure, plus heart rate, movement of foot through the GIT tract, then contraction of urinary bladder. Third portion of diencephalon is subthalamus. Subthalamus, it forms very important component of the basal nuclei, so it helps in the control of movements by forming an intermediate structure in the caudate and putamen loops. The fourth portion of diencephalon is the epithalamus, and epithalamus is composed of three structures. Number one, habenular nuclei, then connections that are called habenular commissure, and pineal gland. As you can see from this diagram, this is very small region of the habenular nucleus, then this portion is pineal gland. First is the habenular nucleus. Habenular nucleus is concerned with the integration of olfactory, visceral, and somatic efferent pathways in association with the blood vessels and pineal cells. This small endocrine, then the second is the pineal gland. The pineal gland, it produces melatonin, and melatonin, it plays a role in the control of sleep-wake cycle, influences sexual development. And the pineal, the most important thing about the pineal gland is that it contains no nerve cells or neurons. The pineal glands converts nerve signals from the sympathetic component of the peripheral nervous system into hormonal signals. Thereby, it links nervous and endocrine structures. Then the summary of the previous lecture and this lecture, the forebrain structure function relationship. The cerebral cortex is the seat of perception, conscious awareness, cognition, and voluntary action. The cortical neurons receive sensory information, form perceptions of the outside world, and command voluntary movements through sensory and motor tracts. The major motor tract includes corticospinal, tract in addition to corticospinal tract. The other is a system of tracts, that is extra pyramidal system. The major sensory tracts includes dorsal column, tract, and spinothalamic tract. In addition to this, spinocerebellar tracts. There are other many sensory pathways that we will discuss in each section in detail. Next, the neurons in the olfactory bulb receive information from cells that sense chemicals in the nose and relays this information to the cerebral cortex for further analysis. Then information from the eyes, ears, and skin is also brought to the cerebral cortex for analysis. Each of the sensory pathways serving vision, hearing, and somatic sensations relays information in the thalamus en route to the cortex. Therefore, we can say that the thalamus, it acts as gateway for the information that enters to the cortex. The axons of each internal capsule carry information to the cortex about the contralateral side of the body, as we have discussed. The hypothalamus, as we discussed, controls the visceral, means autonomic nervous system activities, which regulate body functions in response to the needs of the organism. Thank you very much, dear students, for being with us. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the midbrain and the hindbrain.